But now, an unexpected dinner guest arrives in Shortland Street.
You have got to find a new way of managing the rosters. Driving us into the ground is not the way to go.
Go home, Brenda.
And run the ward a nurse down. Not that you haven't done it before.
I'll cover.
Get out of here.
Sorry about running out like that.
Your poor dad didn't know what to think.
I was with Mum in the restaurant. When I saw you and Dad in the bar, I just panicked.
I know they have their problems, but they are adults.
Yeah, who try to murder each other whenever they're in the same room. That or Dad pulls one of his stunts, you can guarantee it.
I thought Dave could eat here tonight.
It's a nice offer, love. But, might be better if we did it another time, eh? I might pull one of my stunts, whatever they are. It's been lovely to meet you. I think my boy is a very lucky man. Love to your mother.
Oh, Dad, wait.
Mark, look, I'm sorry I embarrass you. I didn't realise that my life was a series of stunts designed to bug you.
You know what I'm talking about.
You need to relax a bit. Too much like your mum.
Oh, don't start with that.
Cheer up, Mark. I'm only here for a few days. I mean, how bad can it be?
Come on, mate, shift it up a gear.
Can I stay home today?
Is it the weekend? No. Are both your legs broken? No.
Why are you so grumpy?
Because I don't get enough sleep and I work too much. I'm like a small boy, I know.
What small boy?
You.
I'm not small.
Enough. Finish that and go and get your bag for school.
I just started eating.
Go upstairs and get your things now.
He hasn't finished.
He had his chance. He didn't muck around too much.
Gee, thanks. Barely a good morning. And oh, by the way, you're a crap parent.
I'm just saying it's okay to put your foot down.
You know, enough of that at work. Maybe if you spent some more time at home, Harry wouldn't be so cranky.
Oh, we work long hours.
Remember in the old days when people worked 40-hour weeks?
Maybe we need to delegate more.
You've got Libby jumping to obey your every command. I've got Brenda.
You really need to sort that out.
Yeah, I'm trying, but the blame is bad, Tom. It's exhausting.
My parents divorced in the mid-90s and I have been copying collateral damage ever since.
I must say, your mum sounded so nice on the phone. And your dad seems a happy sort.
Oh yeah, happy-go-lucky, that's my dad.
It's a pity you're so down on them.
Look, you scored a great family, mine suck.
Mine can be pretty intense too.
Yeah, you scrape a bit. It's only because you care about each other.
I'm suspecting your parents aren't as bad as you make out.
No? My med school graduation, my parents had to be escorted out by security guards. Half cut, screaming at each other in front of my mates, my tutors.
I don't care if they're drunken, gambling axe murderers. I'm just glad they made you.
You say that now.
As long as we keep them apart, worlds won't collide and it'll be fine. Okay?
And Baxter, your last patient is Simone Chapman, abdo pain for investigation. Not even a provisional diagnosis at this stage. Problem?
I know her, that's all.
Well, in the biblical sense, or?
She belongs to my church.
Okay, so if there's any actual problems, let me know. In the meantime, it's another busy day. To our graduates, keep asking questions and learn fast.
Thanks to finally made it in, I see.
One of his patients is from his church, so he'll be belting out alleluias all afternoon.
I need to speak to Lily.
She's specialing Mr. Lawton. I know she's only new, but I feel confident that she can cope.
Sure.
Your problem, is it something that I can deal with?
No, I need to see Lily face to face.
To say sorry about Mr. Brown?
Where's Brenda?
Her car broke down, so she had to catch a taxi and she'll be here in a minute.
I'd like to see her when she turns up.
Rightio.
I was hoping you'd show up.
What happened?
I took your advice and came in. Instead of a checkup, they admitted me. I tried calling, but you must have been busy.
Yeah, I've been off work, sick. Okay, that's a lie. I, kind of fell off the wagon.
Oh, thanks.
Anyway, I'm back now, and I'm gonna make sure that you're okay.
I'm glad.
Those blood tests we did, all clear.
All the tests are clear. Why can't we get any answers?
Oh, sorry, sometimes it happens like this. It's a process of elimination. In the meantime, we'll do more tests to narrow it down. What's our time?
Last one was 37.9.
Feel about the same?
Yep. Still got a migraine.
Okay. We'll back some organise more pain relief for you.
Baxter, could you try praying for me?
I can't. It's not real. It's not in me. It never was.
It's okay. Forget I asked.
I'm sorry. Only God heals people.
We'll take whatever staff you've got. Brilliant. Thanks, Pat. Need a check?
Please.
Where's your trainee?
Making beds, badly.
About all they got for.
The round done. Now I can start some actual work.
Brenda still hasn't turned up. Her taxi broke down as well.
I don't know where she is. I've been trying to call her, but she's not answering.
Excuse me. Do you mind if I swap a patient with Therese?
Who and why?
Simone Chapman. Well, she keeps on asking me to pray for her, and I know that I'm not allowed, so it's getting very difficult.
For goodness sake, just deal with it. Tell her sorry, no, and get on with your work. Have you tried her home phone and mobile?
Just home.
The mood she was in when she left last night, I wouldn't be surprised if she took herself to the nearest bar. Which means, right now, she'll be pulling the pillow off her head and blocking out the noise. Oh, wake up, you cow.
Good morning indeed. How can I help?
I was hoping to catch my son. He's a doctor here. Mark Weston.
Oh, isn't this a nice surprise? Yvonne Jeffries, Tanya's mum.
Dave Weston, delighted.
Lovely to meet you at last.
Me too. It's an exciting time.
Isn't it just? Now, I will page him for you, but I know that they're flat out in there, so it might be a bit of a
wait. No, don't worry about it. I'll catch him later.
Oh, at the big dinner tonight.
The big dinner.
The Jeffries meet the Westons. Historic moment.
Yeah, the big dinner. Yeah, I'm looking forward to that. Look, I won't keep you. I just want to say I've met Tanya, and I think she's absolutely lovely.
I think so too.
By the way, what was the name of that restaurant again?
The Ivy Bar, across the road and to the left.
Ah, I know it. Well, till tonight. Adieu.
Chris. I just wanted to, when am I going to see you again?
I honestly don't know.
Tonight?
I have to get home, I promised Tony.
Then when?
I have a cab today, 3:30 to 4-ish.
Great. Park down the road from my place and wait for me. I won't be late, promise.